How many muscles are there, incidentally, in your fingers? How many?
20 yes. tiny fingers.
One if you play your cards right.
Boy. I'm not going to pay any attention to you
I'll
now.
Put the pencil in.
Oh, Lord bless you.
Oh, rich up here. You're so dirty.
None.
None is the right answer, thank you. There are no muscles in your fingers. Only tendons. The muscles are in the hand and in the forearm that control your fingers. In fact, a way of showing, if you do a sort of spidery thing and then pull in your middle finger like that, do that. All right? Now lift your thumb, tap it up, tap it. Tap your little finger, tap your index finger. Now tap your ring finger. It has no muscle.
Oh,
all it is it, but it has a shared tendon with the middle finger, so it can't even move at all.
That hurt there.
Yeah, it's weird, isn't it? There you have a picture of the musculature of the hand and arm, and you can see there are no muscles there in the fingers. What is it that burns when you set fire to your farts?
You want someone to say methane, don't you?
I'll say it.
No, I really thought it was methane. Yes, everybody thinks it's methane. No, most human beings do not produce methane in their extrusions. It seems that we produce about 3 pints of wind a day.
Released,
pints? Yes, pints. It's measured in pints. Released in 10 to 15 individual episodes.
You get a box set as well. Yes.
Yeah. Oh, you can have a feature-length episode.
So, pyroflatulence is the practice of igniting these episodes. Can lead to serious burns, so don't try it at home, everybody. But methane in the body results from microbes called methanogens. But only about a third of humans have methanogens among their gut flora. So no one knows exactly why. That appears to be genetically determined. And a 2009 study by Arizona State University showed that methane producers are more efficient at converting their undigested food into fat reserves, which, bluntly put, means fat people fart more. The major components of flatus... The major components are all odourless. The distinctive aroma is caused by skatol, indole and hydrogen sulfide. During the Great Plague of London, doctors recommended patients store their farts in a jar and then, when they were feeling unwell, smell them. And apparently, this would help. Anyway, it's usually hydrogen, in fact, that's lit.
But so, as I always say, better out than in.
Definitely.
A bit like Simon Cowell in a lifeboat.
Now, which of your organs most resembles an elephant's trunk?
God. Who wants it, Alan?
No.
Who wants it?
Go on, you go on.
I'm just trying to think of the most humorous way to phrase it.
Yeah, well, no, it's not. It's not penis. It isn't penis.
Isn't it? No.
Well, can your penis do that?
A dangling, pendulous appendage, your penis, and a trunk, but really, truly resembling in structure.
That's not one there, is it?
It's swinging.
Yes. He's got tusks down there.
There's a lot going on.
The elephant can.
It has a.
Yeah. Oh, God.
It does.
Yes. All right. Very amusing. There's an animal that has organs of generation. Let's laugh at that for a long time.
Yeah, but it's quite funny. Yeah.
What is it about the trunk? It's like the trunk.
The prehensility, is that a word?
African elephants have almost like lips which can pick up a blade of grass, prehensile kind of little bits there. But that's the actual tongue itself is interesting. Well, it's a muscle.
Hang on. So
the trunk is the same.
So
our tongue is also a muscle. It's a muscular hydrostat. The reason the trunk can take on any shape is because it's all muscle, and mostly, therefore, water, which you wouldn't think of a muscle, but it's true. And water can't be compressed, of course. Liquids cannot be compressed.
It can. I've had a Capri Sun, and they've got that packet.
And they... where would you find the most pyramids in the world? Yes!
Egypt.
I'm sure I've heard Mexico, but I bet that's wrong as well, is it?
I've seen one. Seen one in Las Vegas.
Yes, there is one in Las Vegas.
Let's go. Switzerland.
Yes, let's try Switzerland.
Switzerland.
That's so sweet. One man appreciates you.
So wait a minute. Joe, Alan and I have all been penalised.
You've
come out ahead by saying Switzerland.
Brilliant. Is it the United States? Are there more pyramids than the United States?
No, it's nearer to Egypt.
Libya, Algeria, Tunisia.
You're in the right part of the world.
Sudan?
It is Sudan, absolutely right. In fact, bizarrely, this is a photograph that I took myself of these Sudanese pyramids. There's about a
hundred... Do your preparation for this show.
What is the travel budget for this show? Where's the licence fee money going? You went all the way over there to take this photo?
Yeah. I made a long documentary about Sudan, and I really, really recommend this, because you go and there is nobody there. It is
massive civil war could be part of the reason.
Yeah, I did. Before the Civil War. So in Egypt, between 118 and 138, in Sudan there are about 220, and they're all in the Meroe area. So this was ancient Nubia, and you can climb them, you can go inside, there's fantastic writing, they had the Meroitic handwriting, incredible carvings.
Are they houses, these ones, or are they burial things?
No, they're burial things, and what's really interesting about them, the Egyptians were clearly for the pharaohs and for the great and the good, they were much more of a meritocracy, and so you get not such wealthy people who had pyramids of their own, and what you can't see here is there was an entire civilization, and from the air you can see the irrigation of tens of thousands of people living there, and then completely destroyed.
What is the collective noun for a group of baboons? Yay.
The Pentagon.
Fantastic. Oddly enough, American politics has a lot to do with it, and not only is the Pentagon an organ of American power, but so is their house.
Capitol Hill, the White House.
The house is known
the
as...
The House of Representatives.
House of Baboons?
It's the Congress.
The Congress.
It's a Congress.
It's a Congress of Baboons.
Yeah, but the reason we ask the question is...
Congress of Baboons.
Very good. But there is a quite interesting fact about a new word that is beginning to replace Congress, and it has a very odd history, this word. It comes from a comedy sketch on BBC television, in a series called Not the 9 o'clock News. There was a sketch called Gerald the Gorilla, in which Rowan Atkinson played it.
And Wild.
He makes mention, furious. That's right, Wild, I was furious, exactly, the production on that album. But, there's a point where he talks about a group, or flange, as we call them, of gorillas. And this was just made up by Richard Curtis, or whoever wrote the sketch, that particular sketch. But it's now on the net, and there is, I can quote you here, from a book called Sex and Friendship in Baboons by Barbara B. Smuts. This is a review.
He's read every book in the world. Yeah.
This is a review on Amazon.com, and it's a serious academic study, and it says, in this marvellous book, Smuts draws from years of painstaking field research in which he followed around a flange of Chakma baboons in the game reserve in Zimbabwe. And that, a word has migrated from a comedy sketch into the internet and is now being used by academics as the official word.